Well, since he announced his presidential bid, President Trump has been involved in a lot of controversy. But this week, he was a victim of what many are calling a cruel and very inappropriate joke. And it has many people wondering, where do we draw the line when it comes to free speech? And political psychologist Dr. Bart Rossi is here this morning with a closer look. And doctor, I think we can all agree, regardless of your political affiliation, this one, the bloody head, crossed the line.
Well, not only did it cross the line, but it was way over the line. And I think we need to take a look at what we should take off the table when it comes to being funny or being comedic, you know? What should be off the table? And first and foremost, violence should be out
right.
of the picture. And I don't know what she was thinking about, Kathy Griffin, but this was a giant mistake. And I think it really needs more than just an apology from her.
Absolutely. But this wasn't the first instance where a president has been attacked in this manner. I mean,
no.
We can go back to the Game of Thrones and President Bush's head on a stake. And then there were things that were done against President Obama. So this violence, this sense of violence toward our president, what does that do to the state of the American people, to our mindset?
Well, what it does is it creates a mental set or a frame of reference, as psychologists say most often, where people tend to think, especially kids, that violence is okay.
It's acceptable.
It's acceptable. It's part of my day. Maybe I won't really report this bully act or this other abrasive act or that violent situation. We need to look at violence as being the exception, not the norm. And I think that what happens here is that we develop certain thinking patterns that mm-hmm. are just not healthy. And Kathy Griffin led into this whole thing, and it really was beyond the pale of reason. And,
yeah.
it makes you think about what happens with people. Why do they actually do this?
Well, that was my next question. Why? I mean, was this a stunt to create mm-hmm. attention for her? What could possibly be the mindset that says, hey, this is okay?
I think it's the mindset where a comedian or someone else pushes the limit, and they think that it might be funny, not realizing that the other side of it is so repulsive and abrasive. And I think she lost track of herself. She lost her compass here in terms of what really is funny.
Absolutely. Now, the one thing I will say about this, if there is, and there really is not anything good out of it, but the one thing that is redeeming is to see both sides, both political parties sort of condemning this act. Even Chelsea Clinton on Twitter spoke out calling this act vile. And so in terms of being good for the country, it was surprising and pleasantly surprising to see both sides lining up saying, hey, no, this is not good.
Well, I think we'd like to see this as a turning point
yes.
where more people, you know, draw the line and say, listen, we can be critical of the president, we can be critical of anybody. Everyone can be criticized,
right.
but we need to take violence off the table, and we need to do this quickly, and we need to be forceful in this as well.
Do you think this speaks to we as a nation being desensitized? Politically, we've become so aggressive. Politically, we've lost sort of our barriers on what's appropriate and what's not. Do you think this speaks to the desensitization?
I think it speaks to extremism and the political spectrum today. Too far to the right, too far to the left. People who are angry, they have what psychologists call retained anger, and over time it boils over and it becomes so abrasive that it's almost into a rage, and that's not healthy for the country or for the political scene.
All right. Dr. Rossi, thanks so much for being with us. We appreciate it. We'll be right back with a check of your weather and traffic.